श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम।
श्रील यामुनाचार्य विरचित स्तोत्र रत्न
नमोचिन्त्यद्भुता क्लिष्ट ज्ञान वैराग्य राशये नाता यमुनये गाद भगवत भक्ति सिंधवे तस्मै नमो मधुजिदंग्रि सरोज तत्व ज्ञानानुराग महिमातिशयंत सीम्ने नाताय नातमुनयेत्र परत्र चापि नित्यं यदीय चरणौ शरणं मदीयम् भूयो नमो परिमिताच्युत भक्ति तत्व ज्ञानामृताब्धि परिवाह शुभैर्वचोभिः लोके वतीर्ण परमार्थ समग्र भक्ति योगाय नाथ मुनये यमिनाम्बराय तत्वेन यच्चिदचिदीश्वर तत्स्वभाव भोगापवर्ग तदुपाय गतिर्बुदारः सन्दर्शयन् निरमिमीत पुराण रत्नम् तस्मै नमो मुनिवराय पराशराय माता पिता युवतयस्तनया विभूतिः सर्वे यदेव नियमेन मदन्वयानाम् आद्यस्य नकुलपतेर्बकुलाभिरामम् श्रीमत्तदङ्घ्रियुगलम् प्रणमामि मूर्ध्ना यन्मूर्ध्नि मे श्रुतिशिरस्तु च भाति यस्मिन् अस्मन्मनोरथ पतः सकलः समेति स्थोष्यामि कुलदनं कुलदैवतं तत् पादारविन्दमरविन्द विलोचनस्य तत्त्वेन यस्य महिमर्णवशीकराणुः शक्यो नमतुमपि सर्वपितामहाद्यैः कर्तुं तदीय महिमस्तुतिमुद्यताय मह्यं नमोऽस्तु कवये निरपत्रपाय यत्वाश्रमावदियतामतिवाप्यशक्तः स्तौम्यैवमेव खलु तेऽपि सदा स्तुवन्तः वेदाश्चतुर्मुखश्च महार्णवन्तः कोमज्जतोरनुकूलाचलयोर्विशेषः किं चैष शक्त्यतिशयेन न तेऽनुकम्प्यः स्तोतापि तु स्तुतिकृतेन परिश्रमेण तत्र श्रमस्तु सुलभो मम मन्दबुद्धेः इत्युद्यमोऽयमुचितो मम चाब्जनेत्र नापेक्षसे यदि ततो भुवनान्यमुनी नालं प्रभो भवितुमेव कुत प्रवृत्तिः एवं निसर्गसुहृदि त्वयि सर्वजन्तोः स्वामिन्न चित्रमिदमाश्रितवत्सलत्वम् स्वाभाविकानवधिकातिशयेषि तृत्वम् नारायण त्वयि न मृष्यति वैदिकः कः ब्रह्मा शिवशतमकः परमस्वरादिति एतेऽपि यस्य महिमार्णव विप्रुषस्ते कश्री श्रियः परमसत्त्वसमाश्रयः कः पुंडरीक नयन पुरुषोत्तम कस्यायुतायुता शतैक कलांशकांसे विश्वं विचित्रचिदचित् प्रविभागवृत्तम् वेदापहार गुरुपात कदैत्यपीडाद् आपद्विमोचन महिष्ट फल प्रदानैः खोन्य प्रजा पशुपति परिपातिकस्य पादोदकेन स शिवस्व शिरो द्रुतेन कस्योदरे हर विरिञ्च मुख प्रपञ्चः घोरक्षतीं मजनिष्ट च कस्य नाभेः क्रान्त्वा निगीर्य पुनरुद्गिरति त्वदन्यः कक्केन वैष परवान् इति शक्यशङ्कः त्वां शीलरूपचरितै परमप्रकृष्ट सत्त्वेन सात्विकतया प्रबलैश्च शास्त्रैः प्रख्यात दैव परमार्थविदां मतैश्च नैवासुर प्रकृतय प्रभवन्ति भोद्धुम् उल्लङ्घित त्रिविध सीम समातिरायी संभावनं तव परिब्रडिमस्वभावम् माया बलेन भवतापि निगुह्यमानम् पश्यन्ति केचिदनिशं त्वदनन्यभावाः यदण्डमण्डान्तरगोचरं च यद् धशोत्तराण्यावरणानि यानि च गुणाप्रदानं पुरुष परं पदम् परात्परं ब्रह्म च ते विभूतयः वशीपदान्यो गुणवान्द्रुजुशुचिः मृदुर्दयालुर्मधुरस्थिरः समः कृतीकृतज्ञस्त्वमसि स्वभावतः समस्तकल्याणगुणामृतो दधिः उपर्युपर्यब्ज भुवोऽपि पूरुषान् प्रकल्प्यते येष तमित्यनुक्रमात् धीरस्त्वदेकैकगुणावदीप्सया सदा स्थिता नोद्यमतोऽतिशेरते त्वदाश्रितानां जगदुद्भवस्थिति प्रणाश संसार विमोचनादयः भवन्ति लीला विदयश्च वैदिकाः त्वदीय गम्भीरमनोऽनुसारिणः नमो नमो वान्मनसातिभूमये नमो नमो वान्मनसैकभूमये नमो नमो नन्त महाविभूतये नमो नमो नन्त दयैकसिन्धवे न धर्मनिष्ठोऽस्मि न चात्मवेदी न भक्तिमान् त्वच्चरणारविन्दे अकिञ्चनोऽनन्यगतिः शरण्य त्वत्पादमूलं शरणं प्रपद्ये न निन्दितं कर्म तदस्ति लोके सहस्रशो यन्न मया व्यदायी सोऽहं विपाकावसरे मुकुन्द क्रन्दामि सम्प्रत्यगति तवाग्रे निमज्जतोऽनन्त बवर्णवन्तः चिरामे कूलमिवासि लब्धेः त्वयापि लब्धं भगवन् इदानीम् अनुत्तमं पात्रमिदं दयायाः अभूतपूर्वं मम पापि किं वा सर्वं सहेमे सहजं हि दुःखम् किन्तु त्वदग्रे शरणागतानम् पराभवो नातनतेऽनुरूपः निरासकस्यापि नतावदुत्सहे महेशहातुं तव पादपङ्कजम् वृषा निरस्तोऽपि शिशुस्तनन्दयो न जातु मातुश्चरणौ जिहासति तवामृतस्यन्दिनिपादपङ्कजे निवेशतामाकतमन्यदिच्छति स्थिते रविन्दे मकरन्दनिर्भरे मधुव्रतो नेक्षुरकं हि वीक्षते वदङ्ग्रिमुद्दिशय कदापि केन चेद् यता तता वापि सकृत्कृतोऽञ्जलिः सदैव मुष्णात्यशुभान्यशेषतः शुभानि पुष्णाति न जातु हीयते उदीर्ण संसारदपशुषुक्षणिम् क्षणेन निर्वप्य परां च निर्वृतिम् प्रयच्छि तत्त्वच्चरणारुणाम्बुज द्वयानुरागामृतसिन्धुशीकरः विलासविक्रान्तपराबरालयम् नमस्यदार्तिक्षपणे कृतक्षणम् धनं मदीयं तव पादपङ्कजम् कदा नु साक्षात् करवाणि चक्षुषा कदा पुनः शङ्करतान्गकल्पक ध्वजारविन्दान्कुशवज्रलाञ्चनम् त्रिविक्रमत्वच्चरणाम्बुजद्वयम् मदीयमूर्धानमलङ्करिष्यति विराजमानोज्ज्वलपीतवाससम् स्मितातसीसूनसमामलच्चविम् निमग्ननाभिं तनुमद्यमुन्नतम् विशालवक्षस्थलशोभिलक्षणम् चकासतं ज्याकिनकर्कषैशुभैः चतुर्भिराजानुविलम्बिभिर्भुजैः प्रियावतं स्वोत्पलकर्णभूषण श्लतालकाबन्धविमर्दशंसिभिः उदग्रपीनां स विलम्बिकुण्डल अलकाबली बन्धुरकम्बुकन्दरम् मुखश्रियान्यककृतपूर्णनिर्मल अमृतांशुबिम्बाम्बुरुहोज्ज्वलश्रियम् प्रबुद्धमुग्धाम्बुजचारुलोचनम् सविभ्रमब्रूलतमुज्ज्वलादरम् शुचिस्मितं कोमलगण्डमुन्नसं ललाटपर्यन्तविलम्बितालकम् स्फुरत्किरीटान्गदहारकण्टिका मणीन्द्रकाञ्चिगुणनूपुरादिभिः रतान्गशङ्कासिगदादनुर्वरैः लसत्तुलस्यावनमालयोज्ज्वलम् चकर्तयस्याभवनभुजान्तरम् तव प्रियं दाम यदीयजन्मभूः जगत्समस्तं यदपाङ्गसंश्रयम् यदर्थमं बोधिरमन्त्यबन्दि च स्ववैश्वरूप्येण सदानुभूतया अप्यपूर्ववद्विस्मयमाददानया गुणरूपेण विलासचेष्टितैः सदा तवैवोचितया तव श्रिया तया सहासीनमनन्तभोगिनी प्रकृष्टविज्ञानबलैकदामनी फणामणिव्रातमयूकमण्डल प्रकाशमानोदरदिव्यदामनी निवाशय्यासन पादुकां शुको पदान वर्षात पवारणादिभिः शरीर भेदैत वशेषतां गतैः यतोचितं शेष इति रिते जनैः दासस्सकाबाहनमासनं द्वजो यस्ते वितानं व्यजनं त्रयीमयः उपस्थितं तेन पुरोगरुद्मता त्वदङ्ग्रिजं मर्दकिनान् कशोभिना त्वदीय भुक्तोज्जितशेषभोजिना त्वया निसृष्टात्मभरेण यद्यता प्रियेण सेनापतिनान्यवेदितात् नुजानन्तम् उदारवीक्षणैः हता हि लक्लेशमलैस्वभावतः त्वदानुकूल्यैकरसैतवोचितैः गृहीत तत्तत्परिचारसाधनैः निषेव्यमानं सचिवै यतोचितम् अपूर्वनानारसभावनिर्भर प्रबद्धया मुग्धविदग्धलीलया क्षणानुपक्षिप्तपराधिकालया प्रहर्षयन्तं महिषीं महाभुजम् अचिन्त्यदिव्याद्भुतनित्ययौवन स्वभावलावण्यमयामृतोदधिं श्रियश्रियं भक्तजनैकजीवितं समर्थमापत्सकमर्तिकल्पकम् भवन्तमेवानुचरन् निरन्तरम् प्रशान्तनिःशेषमनोरथान्तरः कदाहमैकान्तिकनित्यकिङ्करः प्रहर्षयिष्यामि सनातजीवितः दिगशुचिमविनीतं निर्भयम् परमपुरुषयोऽहं योगिवर्याग्रगण्यैः विधिशिवसनकाद्यै ध्यातुमत्यन्तदूरम् तव परिजनभावं कमये कामवृत्तः अपराधसहस्रभाजनम् पतितं भीमभवर्णवोदरे अगतिं शरणागतं हरे कृपया केवलमात्मसात्कुरु अविवेकगणान्दधिन्मुखे बहुधा सन्ततदुःखवर्षिणी भगवन् भव दुर्दिने पतः स्खलितं मामवलोकयाच्युत न मृषा परमार्थमेव मे शृणु विज्ञापनमेकमग्रतः यदि मे न दयिष्यसे ततो धयनीय तव नाथ दुर्लभः तदहं त्वद्रुतेन नाथवान् मद्रुते त्वं दयनीयवान् च विधिनिर्मितमेतमन्वयम् भगवन् पालय मास्म जीहपः वपुरादिषु योऽपि कोऽपि वा गुणतोऽसानि यथा तथाविदः तदयं तव पादपद्मयोः अहमद्यैव मया समर्पितः मम नाथ यदस्ति योऽस्म्यहम् सकलं तदितवैव माधव नियतस्वम् इति प्रबुद्धदीः अथवा किं नु समर्पयामि ते अवबोधितवान्यिमां यथा मयि नित्यां भवदीयतां स्वयम्। कृपयैवं अनन्यभोग्यतां भगवन् भक्तिम् अपि प्रयच्छ मे तव दास्य सुकैकसङ्गिनां भवनेषु अस्तु अपि कीटजन्म मे इतरावसतेषु मस्मभूद् अपि मे जन्म चतुर्मुखात्मना सकृत्वदाकार विलोकनाशया तृणीकृतान्नुत्तम भुक्तिमुक्तिभिः महात्मभिर्मां बलोक्यतां नय क्षणेऽपि ते तद्विरहोति दुःसहः न देहं न प्राणान्न च सुखम् अशेषाभिलषितम् न चात्मानं नान्यत् किमपि तव शेषत्वविभवात् बहिर्भूतं नातक्षणमपि सहेयातुषतदा विनाशं तत्सत्त्वं मधुमतन विज्ञापनमिदम् धुरन्तस्यानादेरपरिहरणीयस्य महतो निहीनाचारोऽहं नृपशुरशुभस्यास्पदमपि धया सिन्धो बन्धो निरवधिकवात्सल्यजलदे तपस्मारं स्मरं गुणगणम् इति चामि गतभिः अनिच्छन्नप्येवं यदि पुनरितीच्छन्निव राजः तमश्चन्नच्छद्मस्तुतिवचनभङ्गीं मरजयम् तथापीत्तं रूपं वचनमवलम्यापि कृपया त्वमेव एवं भूतं धरणिधर मे शिक्षय मनः पिता त्वं माता त्वं दयिततनयस्त्वं प्रियसुहृद् त्वमेव त्वं मित्रं गुरुरसि गतिश्चासि जगताम् त्वदीयस्त्वद्भृत्यस्तव परिजनत्वद्गतिरहम् प्रपन्नश्चैवं सत्यहमपि तवैवास्मि हि वरः जनित्वाहं वंशे महति जगति ख्यातयशसां शुचिनां युक्तानां गुणपुरुषतत्त्वस्थितिविदां निसर्गाद्येव त्वच्छरणकमलैकान्तमनसाम् अदोदपापात्मा शरणदनिमज्जामि तमसि अमर्यादक्षुद्रच्चलमतिरसूया प्रसवभूः कृतघ्नो दुर्मानि स्मर परवशो वञ्चनपरः नृशंसपापिष्टः कथमहमितो दुःखजलदेः अपाराद् उत्तीर्णस्तव परिचरेयं चरणयोः रघुवर यद् अभूस्त्वं तादृशो वायसस्य प्रणत इति दयालुर्यच्च चैत्यस्य कृष्ण प्रतिभवमपराद् दुर्मुग्धसायुज्यदो भूः वद किमपदमागस्तस्य तेऽस्ति क्षमायाः ननु प्रपन्नः सहृदे वनात् तवाहमस्मीति च याचमानः तवानुकम्प्य स्मरत प्रतिज्ञां मदेकवर्जं किमिदं व्रतं ते अकृत्रिमत्वच्चरणारविन्द प्रेम प्रकर्षावधिमात्मवन्तम् पितामहं नाथ मुनिं विलोक्य प्रसीदमद्वृत्तमचिन्तयित्वा
इति श्रीलयामुनाचार्य विरचितं स्तोत्ररत्नं सम्पूर्णम्।
हरि तत्सत्।
Translation of Sri Stotra Ratna of Sri Yamunacharya.
I offer my obeisances to the inconceivable, wonderful and peaceful Natha Muni, who is an ocean of transcendental love for the Lord and the personification of divine knowledge and renunciation. I offer my respects to my spiritual master, Natha Muni, whose lotus feet are my eternal shelter in this world and the next. He represents the highest point of spiritual truth, which is knowledge of and love for the lotus feet of Lord Madhujit, the slayer of the Madhu demon. Obeisances again to Natha Muni, the best of those who are sense-controlled. His teachings on the science of devotion to Lord Achyuta are an unlimited ocean of nectar which have now descended to this earth. I offer my respectful obeisances unto the best of the sages, Parashara, who mercifully composed the gem of the Puranas, Vishnu Purana, and in that book taught the truth about the nature of matter, spirit, the supreme personality of Godhead, material sense gratification, liberation, and the means of attaining liberation. Sri Nammarvar, the origin of our disciplic succession, is the object of great respect for all Sri Vaishnavas, and for us, he is our father, mother, wealth, sons, daughters, and everything. Bowing my head, I offer my respectful obeisances to his feet, which are as beautiful as blossoming bakula flowers. I shall now glorify lotus-eyed Lord Krishna's lotus feet, which are splendidly manifest on my head and on the heads of all the Vedas, which are the place where all the pathways of my desires converge, and which are the deity and the great treasure of our family. I am so proud and shameless that I shall now offer respectful obeisances to myself, a poet intent on praising the Supreme Personality of Godhead, whose glories are like a great ocean, even a drop of which cannot be properly understood by Brahma, Shiva, and all the demigods. Now, even though I am weak and incompetent, as far as I have any knowledge or intelligence, I shall glorify the Lord until I must stop from exhaustion. The Vedas and the Brahma's many mouths always glorify the Lord. What is the difference between a great mountain and a speck of dust when both are plunged in the depths of the ocean? O lotus-eyed Lord, this poet does not expect to earn your mercy by a display of powerful eloquence. His intelligence is dull, and these prayers were composed with great labor. O Lord, if you had not glanced on them, these worlds would not exist. Without your glance, how can anything happen? O Lord, it is not surprising that although you are everyone's friend, you especially love those who take shelter of you. O Lord Narayana, what learned Vedic scholar will not accept you as the all-powerful and unlimited personality of Godhead? Brahma, Shiva, Indra, and the liberated residents of Vaikuntha are but drops in the ocean of your transcendental glory. What is the splendor of the goddess of fortune? Who is the shelter of the pure devotees? Who is the supreme person? In a fraction of a 100 million millionth part
of whom is this world, filled with wonderful spiritual and material variety, manifested. Who, by giving the most precious gifts and by removing a host of calamities, such as the troubles brought by the demons, the theft of the Vedas, and a host of heavy sins, protects Brahma and Shiva? The water from whose feet does auspicious Shiva carry on his head? In whose abdomen in this material world, headed by Brahma and Shiva manifested? Who protects this world? From whose navel was this world born? But for you, who jumps over the world, devours it and then spits it out? Who can be considered greater than you? O my Lord, those influenced by demonic principles cannot realize you, although you are clearly the supreme by dint of your exalted activities, forms, character, and uncommon power, which are confirmed by all the revealed scriptures in the quality of goodness and the celebrated transcendentalists in the divine nature. O my Lord, everything within material nature is limited by time, space, and thought. Your characteristics, however, being unequaled and unsurpassed, are always transcendental to such limitations. You sometimes cover such characteristics by your own energy, but nevertheless, your unalloyed devotees are always able to see you under all circumstances. This material universe, everything moving within it, the 10 coverings around it, the modes of nature, the unmanifested stage of matter, the Purushavatara, the supreme spiritual world, and the supreme Brahman are all your opulences. You are controlled by the love of your devotees. You are generous, virtuous, straightforward, honest, pure, gentle, merciful, charming, steadfast, equal to all, blissful, wise, and saintly. You are a nectar ocean of all auspicious transcendental qualities. Desiring to measure one of your transcendental qualities, the words of the Vedas again and again multiply by 100 times with the qualities of the demigod Brahma. Although eternally engaged in this way, Vedas cannot cross beyond even one of your qualities. The creation, maintenance, and destruction of the material universes, the granting of liberation from the cycle of birth and death, a host of other actions you playfully perform, and the words of the Vedas, which are the thoughts sheltered deep in your heart, are all meant for the benefit of they who take shelter of you. Obeisances, obeisances to you, who are beyond the power of words and mind. Obeisances, obeisances to you, the only proper object for the wise's words are the mind's thoughts. Obeisances, obeisances to you, the master of limitless powers and opulences. Obeisances, obeisances to you, who are a limitless ocean of mercy. I am not a virtuous person, fixed in the principles of religious conduct, and neither am I a great transcendentalist, awakened to spiritual knowledge. In addition to this, I don't have the slightest trace of devotion for your lotus feet. O refuge of the devotees, although I am so unqualified, please permit me to take shelter under your lotus feet. For I am now lost in this material world. I do not possess anything of value, and I have no place to turn. In this world, there is not a single abominable deed I have not done thousands of times. Now that my sins are bearing fruit and I have no place to turn, I come before you. I weep and cry out, O Mukunda! Drowning for a long time in the limitless ocean of repeated birth and death, I have now attained you, who are like a safe shore. And you, O Lord, have now attained the perfect object for your mercy. What unprecedented calamity has not already fallen on me? I always suffer. Suffering has become second nature to me. O Lord, it is not right that they who have taken shelter of you be defeated in this way. O Lord, even if you push me away, I cannot leave your lotus feet. Even if angrily pushed away, an infant can never leave his mother's feet. How can my heart wish anything else now that it is placed at your lotus feet, which are overflowing with nectar? In the presence of a honey-filled lotus, a bee does not even see a thorny, dried-up Ikshuraka flower. Placed by anyone at any time or even only once, palms folded at your feet dispel all inauspiciousness and create great good fortune. The benefit obtained from those folded palms will never be lost, quickly extinguishing the forest fire of repeated birth and death. A single drop from the nectar ocean of love for your reddish lotus feet brings great transcendental bliss. When with my own eyes will I see your lotus feet, which playfully stepped from the bottom to the top of the material world, which quickly remove the sufferings of the surrendered souls, and which are my only treasure? O Lord Trivikrama, when will your lotus feet, which bear the marks of the conch shell, disc, Kalpavruksha tree, flag, lotus, elephant gourd, and thunderbolt, adorn my head? O Lord, dressed in splendid yellow garments, O Lord, as dark as a smiling Atasi flower, O Lord, whose navel is deep, O Lord, whose waist is thin, O tall Lord, O Lord, whose broad chest bears a splendid mark, O Lord, splendid with four arms that are handsome with marks of the bowstring that reach to your knees and that praise the touch of your beloved's garland, lotus, earrings, loosened hair and ornaments. O Lord, whose conch shell neck is handsome with wavy locks of hair and earrings hanging over your broad shoulders. O Lord, the splendor of whose face shames the splendor of the lotus and the spotless full moon. O Lord, whose eyes are as handsome as charming newly blossomed lotuses. O Lord, who has graceful eyebrow vines. O Lord, whose lips are glorious. O Lord, who smiles splendidly. O Lord, whose cheeks are delicate and soft. O Lord, who has a raised nose. O Lord, whose wavy locks of hair touch your forehead. O Lord, splendid with glistening crown, bracelets, necklace, Kaustubha gem, belt, anklets, many ornaments, disc, conch, sword, club, bow, glorious garlands of tulasi and forest flowers. O Lord, who made a home for your consort between your arms. O Lord, whose dear transcendental abode is her place of birth. O Lord, whose sidelong glance is the resting place of all the worlds. O Lord, who churned the ocean for her sake. O Lord, who with the eternal vision of your supreme handsomeness, pastimes and virtues, fills the goddess of fortune with unprecedented wonder. O Lord, seated with her on the coils of Ananta, which are the abode of great knowledge and strength, and which are resplendent with many glittering jewels on Lord Ananta's hoods. O Lord, for whose sake Ananta assumes many shapes to become your residence, bed, throne, sandals, garments, pillow, umbrella, parasol, and many other objects, and in this way has become known to the people as your Shesha. O Lord, before whom stands Garuda, who bears your splendid footprints and who is your servant, friend, carrier, throne, flag, canopy, fan, and three Vedas. O Lord, who with merciful glances approves every request made by the dear general of your army, Vishvaksena, who eats the remnants of your food and to whom you have given complete authority. O Lord, appropriately served in many ways by a host of companions, free from all troubles and filled with the nectar of love for you. O mighty Am Lord, pleasing your queen with charming and clever pastimes that awaken the sweet nectars of many kinds of transcendental love and make many ages seem like a moment. O inconceivable, glorious, wonderful, eternally youthful Lord, O nectar ocean of transcendental handsomeness, O splendor of the goddess of fortune, O life and soul of the devotees, O powerful Lord, O friend in times of need, O Kalpavriksha tree to they who offer prayers. By serving you constantly, one is freed from all material desires and is completely pacified. When shall we engage as your permanent eternal servant and always feel joyful to have such a perfect master? Fie on me! I am unclean, proud, merciless, and shameless. O Supreme Person, I still earn to become your companion, an attainment Brahma, Shiva, the four Kumaras, and the best of the yogis consider far beyond their reach. O Lord Hari, please mercifully accept this person who is the storehouse of thousands of offenses, who has fallen into the terrible ocean of repeated birth and death, who has no place to go, and who now begs shelter from you. O Lord, O infallible one, please glance on me from the right path fallen into the calamity of repeated birth and death, where all directions are darkened with clouds of ignorance and filled with the constant monsoon of sufferings. Let us submit one piece of information before you. Dear Lord, it is not at all false, but it is full of meaning. It is this: if you are not merciful upon us, then it will be very, very difficult to find more suitable candidates for your mercy. Without you, I have no master, and without me, you have no suitable candidate for your mercy. This is our eternal relationship, ordained by fate. O Lord, please protect me. Do not reject me. Whatever I possess in terms of this body and its paraphernalia, and whatever I have from the modes of nature, today I offer at your lotus feet. An enlightened person prays, my Lord, O husband of the goddess of fortune, myself and everything I own is already eternally your property. How then is it possible for me to offer anything to you? I know that I am eternally your property. O Lord, please kindly give me pure devotion service. Let me take birth even as an insect in the home of they whose only happiness is your service. Let me not take birth even as Lord Brahma in the home of any other people. Please place me within the sight of the great souls from whom you cannot bear even a moment's separation, and who, earning for a single glimpse of your transcendental form, consider both impersonal liberation and the most intense sense pleasure worthless as a blade of straw. O Lord, I cannot tolerate for a moment my body, its breathing, the happiness everyone wants, myself, or anything else kept apart from you. Let them perish hundreds of times. O Lord Madhusudana, this is my actual wish. This is my request to you. O ocean of mercy, O limitless ocean of fatherly love, even though I am misbehaved, animalistic, and a storehouse of great limitless, beginningless sins, because I meditate again and again on the great host of your transcendental virtues, I am able to desire in this way without any fear. Although I have no such desire to praise you, as if I did desire to praise you, I have written these prayers that are only a trick of passion and ignorance. O maintainer of the earth, please kindly accept these words and please teach my heart what is right. You are my father, you are my mother, you are my beloved son, you are my well-wisher, you are my friend, you are my master, you are the shelter of the universes, I am your property, I am your servant, I am your follower. I have you as the goal of my life. I am surrendered to you. I am your dependent. Even though I was born in a great family of pure Brahmanas, famous in this world, engaged in your service, fully aware of the truth about the Supreme Person and the modes of matter and their hearts by nature placed only at your lotus feet, still, O giver of shelter, I have become the most sinful person, sinking lower and lower into the darkness of ignorance. How will I, uncivilized, degraded, fickle, a breeding ground of envy, ungrateful, proud, overcome by lust, addicted to cheating, cruel and sinful, be able to cross this shoreless ocean of pain and serve your lotus feet? O Lord Raghuvara, you were kind to a crow that bowed down to offer you respect. O Lord Krishna, you granted Sayujya Mukti to Shishupala, who offended you in every birth. O Lord, please tell me, what offense will you not forgive? Do you remember your promise that if a person once surrenders to you and says, O Lord, I am yours, you will give your mercy to him? Why am I excluded from your promise? Not thinking of what I have done, but looking instead at my grandfather, Nathamuni, a great saint full of sincere love for your lotus feet, please be kind to me.
Thus ends the translation of Sri Stotra Ratna of Sri Yamuna Acharya.